Now let's turn to the implementation of the display method. It's supposed to display a choice question in this format. First, the text of the question, then all of the choices, and we put a 1, 2, 3, 4 in front of each of the choices in case the poor test taker is too frazzled to figure out the numbers themselves. It's easy enough to do this part. All we have to do is loop through the choices and print them with a number in front of them. And since this has nothing to do with learning about inheritance, I'm just going to give you this code. It's right here. So we print the number of the ith choice and the ith item. Actually, not quite, because in Java, the choices have indexes 0, 1, 2, and 3, and we choose the more traditional 1, 2, 3, 4, which accounts for the I plus 1 over here. The hard part is to display the text of the question. Again, the question text is in the superclass object, and we can't get at it directly. Let's have a look at the superclass. Here is the question text. Do we have any method that lets us read it? None of these. But we could call display and then it would print it. That's just what we need. Let's do it. Here I'll call display. That should display the text. And then here I'm displaying these choices. We'll run the demo. Ooh, something very bad happened. I got a stack overflow error. Now that's technical lingo for having a method that keeps calling itself. Why itself? See, the method is called display, and here it calls itself. That's a problem. I didn't want to call my own method. I wanted to call the display method of the question class. So my difficulty is that I have two methods called display in the superclass and in the subclass, and they have the same name. That's exactly what always happens when you override a method. Now there's a special syntax for invoking the superclass method, and it looks like that. You simply say super.display. Go ahead and give that a try and fix up the display method.